Alright, hello everyone, and welcome back to the daily update of my 1000 day challenge. This is day 83, so let's get things started. First and foremost, you'll notice the balance remains the same. Even though I'm in long position, I do not update the balance until the trade has been closed. Alright, in terms of the quick market update in terms for the S&P 500 and also ASHR, today you realize that a little bit late I'm doing the update, so the market is actually already open. That said, I wouldn't be taking into consideration today price action at the moment itself. I'll just be taking into consideration yesterday close. So what I do see over here is still somewhat like a neutral pattern itself, because you've got a high, a lower high, a low, but a higher low. But pending if today we do close lower, that is where we transit to a short-term bearish market structure. And I've also redrawn this green region, which is where I'm interested to add in terms of my dollar cost averaging approach as well. So that's for S&P 500. And similarly for Nasdaq, what I'm looking to add is potentially over here or even over there. So I would potentially draw over here. This could be another region where I could look to add in a bit before it even reaches here, which I do see potentially these 200 simple moving average and the 150 simple moving average may actually go up, and at that point in time, say maybe in another month's time, especially when the US presidential election does take place in the coming weeks ahead. Say, I think if I remember correctly, it's around the fourth or the first week of November. So yeah, that could result in some volatility in terms of the price itself. All right. As for ASHR, you can see that it's still consolidating very nicely within this tight spot. So in the meantime, I do lean towards further potential upside. But of course, if you can see the S&P 500 and Nasdaq do fall further, potentially there could be some retracement happening for ASHR that is dragged down, that's dragging down the market as well. But it seems that it's rather resilient as of this point in time. And for KWEB, it seems to be a little bit more bearish. It's seemingly breaking down right now. But of course, if I just look at yesterday's close, it's still in a very nice consolidation pattern. So if it does fall along this region, which I will drag it up a bit, because as moving averages move up, I tend to also move up my buying point as well, or a good strategic point to buy in as well. And for Bitcoin wise, it is definitely really strong. So I'm still definitely trailing from this setup, which I've entered over here that I mentioned. So on the 4-hourly chart, there is where I told you the entry was. So it was based on this particular pullback. I told you that I didn't close it. I would not want to close it until it closed below this low. And fortunately, it didn't trigger below here before it goes up. And I was able to just weather through this temporary down period before it actually breaks up nicely. And then I took some little profit around here. So I'm actually still trading my stop loss happily now. So because you can see that the price is very much above this 20 exponential moving average on the 4-hourly chart. So I do see that potentially there could be some sort of retracement and pullback. I will not close the trade until price close below the low of this candlestick, which you can see is 12680. So until price closes below it, I will not be closing my trade. That's my most aggressive way of trailing stop loss, because I see a very exponential spike in that. So there's a very aggressive stop loss. I wouldn't use this 20 exponential because I will be giving back, potentially I could give back a lot more profit. So there's just a different way of approach that I use when it comes to different market condition that I see. All right, so basically that's about it. And I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.